गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, जय स्वामी नारायण। आफ्टर मिड सेशन वी आर कंटिन्यू विथ यूनिट नंबर 7 नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी सेमिस्टर 7 INS इंफॉर्मेशन एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। टिल डेट वी आर लर्न सो मैनी ऑथेंटिकेशन प्रोटोकॉल, डिजिटल सिग्नेचर स्टैंडर्ड्स इन विच वी आर सी द फेडरल इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोसेसिंग स्टैंडर्ड which is used to specify the suite of algorithms. Then we are continue with many protocols like Kerberos. It is just IDAP, short nodes and mediums. Then we are learn a computer network authentication protocol, various nodes, various mutual authentications and X.509 directories, plus few central authentication services. Then we are start with Active Directory service with Windows 2000 and Windows. Now today we are learn a few part of revisions of unit number 7. The first outline and topics are digital signatures, authentication protocols, digital signature standards, application authentication techniques like Kerberos, then X.509 directory, authentication services, and active directory service of Windows NT or Windows 2000. First, this is a revision. Digital signature is to provide the ability to verify author, date and time of signatures. Get it? Digital signatures is like handwritten signatures are unique to each single. Digital signature solutions provider such as a DocSign follow a specific protocol. Which one? It is called as a PKI. PKI require the provider to use a mathematical algorithm to generate two long numbers called a keys. One key is a public and one key is a private. It is also used to authenticate a message content. It must be verified by third parties to resolve a dispute. It's easiest way to get a digital signatures online from e-mujras with a paperless process and get a online quickly paperless process. This is for a practical approach only. Digital signatures use many protocols for security and algorithm, but not simply algorithm. It is a mathematical algorithm to generate a two long numbers. Once again I repeat, it is called as a keys. There are few properties are there. It must depend on the message sign. It must use information unique to sender to prevent both forgery and denial. It must be relatively easy to procedure. It must be relatively easy to recognize and verify. It must be computationally infeasible to fraud. Be practical, save digital signature in storage. There are few data structures are available there for storage a digital signature. The categories of DS, that means digital signatures, is a direct and arbitrary. Direct digital signatures is involved only sender and receiver. Two parties are connected. Is assumed the receiver has sender's public key. This is a revision part. Digital signature made by sender signing entire message or has with private key. I hope you remember a hash function. In last unit we are seen many technical parameters in a hash functions, which is the number of permutations, number of bits, few parity bits are also available there. Okay, it can encrypt using receiver's public key. Important that the sign first, then encrypt the message and signature. The security depends on sender's private key, which is not shared to all. Only authenticated person having rights to access a private key for decrypt a particular security algorithm. This is a map how this figure is elaborate the confidentiality, authentication and a digital signatures, in which we are mentioned the few steps and the mathematical calculations of various functions for encryption and decryption. The weakness of direct digital signatures: the validity of scheme depend on security of sender's private key. This is weakness or limitations. If a sender later wish to deny sending a particular message, the sender can claim that the private key was lost, misplaced key or stolen, and that someone else forged his or her signature. यहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं unauthorized access. One example is to require every signed message to include a timestamp. एक message को आप security provide कर रहे हो, digital signature apply कर रहे हो, it's include a particular timestamp. There are certain durations of time between process. And to require prompt report of compromise key to a central authority. This is a part of administrator. Then arbitrate digital signatures is involved the use of arbiter A. It's validate any signed message, then dated and sent to recipient. Then a destination location. It's required a suitable level of trust. This can be implemented with either a private or public key algorithm. Arbiter may or may not be able to see a message. Authentication protocol is use to convince parties of each other identity and to exchange a session key. Maybe one way or a mutual. Key issues to confidentiality to protect the session key and timeless to prevent a replay attack. Published protocol are often found to have flaw and need to be modified. There are few digital signature standards also available there. Is the Federal Information Processing Standard is specifying the suite of algorithm that can be used to generate a digital signatures established by the United States National Institute of Standard and Technology in 1994. The four revisions to the initial specification have been released. It defined a digital signature algorithm. It contains a definition of RSA signatures based on definition contained with PKCS. PKCS is the first of the family of standard called the Public Key Cryptography Standard, PKCS. Full form आपको memorize करना है. It is the Public Key Cryptography Standards published by RSA Laboratories. Okay. This is for knowledge. Here we see in the published protocol are often found to have flaw and need to be modified. This is a part of DSS. DSS means Digital Signature Standards. Mutual authentication is a replay attack where a valid signed message is copied and later resent. Here we see a simple replay. Repetition that can be logged, repetition that cannot be detected, backward replay without the modification. Here in simple replay, the opponent simply copy a message and reply it later. An opponent can reply timestamp message with the valid time window. In repetition that cannot be detected, this situation could arise because the original message could have been suppressed and did not arrive at its destination, only the replay message arrives. At last, the backward replay without modification. This is a reply back to the message sender. The countermeasures to avoid replay attack, how to protect from this kind of attack. First is a timestamp, need to synchronize the clocks. Party A in timestamps, here you must remember the party A, that means a source. Accept a message, वो message receive करता है as a fresh only. If the message contain a timestamp that A's judgment is a close enough to a knowledge of current time, this approach require that clock among the various participants be synchronized. हर एक जो भी नोड से जहाँ से मैसेज ट्रांसमिट हो रहा है वहाँ पे टाइम स्टैम्प के हिसाब से आप जो डेटा बीट्स ट्रांसफ़र कर रहे हैं वो आपको पता होना चाहिए. दैट्स कॉल अ टाइम स्टैम्प. अ चैलेंज और रिस्पॉन्स यूजिंग अ यूनिक नोड्स. अ पार्टी ए, यहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं पार्टी ए एक्सपेक्टिंग अ फ्रेश मैसेज फ्रॉम बी. फर्स्ट सेंड्स बी अ नोड्स, दैट मीन्स अ चैलेंज and require that the subsequent message received from B contain the correct nodes value. जब तक आप चैलेंज मैसेज रिसीव नहीं करते तब तक आपको रिस्पॉन्स मस्ट नोटेड फ्रॉम अ रिसीवर इज अ पार्टी बी. ओके, देन यूजिंग ए सिमेट्रिक एनक्रिप्शंस एज डिस्कस प्रीवियसली वी कैन यूज अ टू लेवल हायरार्की ऑफ कीज. यूजुअली with a trusted key distribution center, that means a KDC, each party share own master key with KDC. It generate a session key used for connection between parties. The master key used to distribute it is to them. Then is an random sort this protocol. Here we use the original third party key distribution protocol. Third party key distribution protocol is the major advantage of direct digital signatures and according to digital signature standards as per defined by National Institute of Standards and Technology. Okay, for session between A and B mediated by KDC. The protocol overview, here you see the mathematical calculations of the two parties are the A and B, and then use the KDC. It is used to securely distribute a new session key for communication between source to destination, then party A and B, but is vulnerable to a reply attack. If an old session key has been compromised, अगर old key जो public key और private key आपने use की है वो compromise हुई है तो that means your system is vulnerable. That means the problem in authentication and confidentiality. इसके लिए हमने क्या देखा था, timestamp and response. That means noise. ये दोनों आपको remind करने हैं, ठीक है, जो हमने last presentation में last slide में आपने देखा. Then Denning as a protocol is a Denning 81 presented the following. This is not a part of syllabus for knowledge only. Here you can see the algorithm and the various steps in which the parties are communicated between the source and destinations. First, second, third and fourth and fifth. Here you see in the steps the A send a request to KDC by particular IDs. This is the identification of party A and B. Same as a KDC acknowledge to party A, then A to B, B to A and A to B. How to communication? This is just elaborate the sequence of securing your data and transmission or number of bits in a secure manner by using a Denning as a protocol. Timestamp, once again I repeat, timestamp prevent reply but require synchronized clocks. Clock must be synchronized at each level of a communication. Then one-way authentications is required when sender and receiver are not in communication at the same time, like email. Header in clear so can be delivered by email system using a symmetric encryption. You are already unit 1 to 4. We are seeing the many encryption and decryption standards. in which here refined use of KDC but can't have final exchange of nouns. Here you see the step number 1, 2 and 3, same as above slides. Here you see the figures and the numbers. Does not protect against replies. This could delay on timestamp in message to email. Delay make this problematic. That's why we are used the symmetric encryption. Then we are used sometimes the public key encryptions. It's having a range of approach based on the use of public key encryption. It must need to ensure have correct public key for other parties. It's using a central authentication server. Authentication server is shortly called as AS. The various protocol exist using timestamps or nonces. Here is the example of algorithm and the steps of how to authenticate your data. Then DSS, Digital Signature Standards. Here we see the US government approved the signature schemes by NIST, you already know, and NSA in early 90s is published as a FIPS 186 in 1991. It's revised further in 1993-6 and then 2000. It uses the SHA as algorithm. Unit number 6, the entire chapter is based on the hash algorithm. Secure hash algorithm, you are also learned with so many examples. For revision, you must revise unit number 6, lecture number 3, 4 and 5. The link is the public now. And you must revise, and if any doubt, you contact me. DSS is the standard, DSA is the algorithm, FIPS 186 by 2 under bracket 2000 is include the alternative RSA and elliptic curve signature variance. It here you must remember it define a DSA contain a definition of RSA signatures. RSA signatures क्या है वो आपको पता होना चाहिए. RSA means Revis, Shumi and Adelman is one of the first public key crypto system and is a widely used for secure data transmission. It is an initial letter of surnames of Ron and Revis, Hardy and Samir and Leonard Adelman, who publicly described the algorithm in 1997. DSA, it create a 320 bit signature with 512 to 1024 bit security, is smaller and faster than RSA. It is used for digital signature scheme only. The security depends on difficulty of computing distributed logarithms. This is an algorithm. You already studies. Here we are use the two approach. First is RSA and DSS. DSS means Digital Standard Signatures. DSA signature creations. How to create signatures? To sign a message, M is considered as the sender. It generate a random signature key K, but before that you must see the condition K less than Q. K must be random and be destroyed after use and never be reused. Then the computer signature is the pair by using the equations R is equal to under bracket GK under bracket mode 5 bracket close, then another bracket the mode Q, same as a S is for signature. Same figure you are seen here. It send the signatures of under bracket R, comma S with message M. This is a steps behind how to create DSA signatures. Authentication applications. We developed to support application level authentication and digital signatures. We discussed the Kybros, a private key authentication service. We also discussed X.509 directory, और पब्लिक की डायरेक्टरी ऑथेंटिकेशन सर्विस। नाउ फर्स्ट स्टार्ट विथ द कीब्रोस। व्हाट इज कीब्रोस? इज ऑथेंटिकेशन सर्विस डेवलप इज अ पार्ट ऑफ MIT's अचना प्रोजेक्ट। इज प्रोवाइड सेंट्रलाइज प्राइवेट की थर्ड पार्टी ऑथेंटिकेशन इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड नेटवर्क। इट इज यूज फॉर यूजर इज अलाउ यूजर द एक्सेस सर्विस डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड द नेटवर्क इज विदाउट नीडिंग टू ट्रस्ट ऑल वर्क स्टेशन रेदर ऑल ट्रस्ट सेंट्रल ऑथेंटिकेशन सर्वर्स। मोस्टली टू वर्जन इन यूज फॉर एंड फाइव। देन वाई वी नीड कीब्रोस? द फर्स्ट इज नॉट ट्रस्टेड वर्क स्टेशन टू आइडेंटिफाई देयर यूजर्स करेक्टली in an open distributed environment. The three kind of threats you must identify is a pretending to be another use from the workstation, sending a request from impersonate workstation, reply attack to gain service, or disrupt operations. Here the only we are considers elliptic curve digital signature algorithm. Elliptic curve digital signature algorithm is offer a variant of digital signature algorithm. Okay, this is for knowledge. Why we need Kibros? So continue. The solution is a building elaborate authentication protocol at each server. I repeat, the building elaborate authentication protocol as each server. A centralized authentication server is also available. This is a solution. Then requirements of Kibros is a secure, reliable, transparent and scalable. Why it's secure? Because the opponent does not find it to be the weak link. Reliable because should be able to back up another. And transparent because it not be aware of authentication. And scalable, the system support a large number of client and servers. That's why it scalable. In Kibros, you need to first remember that it is a computer network authentication protocol that work on basis of tickets to allow a nodes communicating over a non-secure network to prove their identity to one another in a secure manner. This is a main use of Kibros. The protocol was named after the characters from Greek mythology. The ferocious three-headed cart of heads. Its designers aim it primarily it at a client-server model, and it provides a mutual authentication. अभी now question आपके दिमाग में आएगा कि mutual authentication क्या है? It's a simple two-way authentication. Is referred to two parties authenticated each other at the same time. Is being a default mode of authentication in some protocol. Okay, in which both the user and server verify each other's identity. दोनों साइड से आपको क्या वेरीफाई करना है? टू पार्टीज द म्यूचुअल ऑथेंटिकेशन आइडेंटिटी वेरीफाई करनी है, ठीक है? Kibros प्रोटोकॉल मैसेज आर प्रोटेक्टेड अगेंस्ट एयरड्रॉपिंग एंड रिप्लाई अटैक। रिप्लाई अटैक क्या है? इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ नेटवर्क अटैक विच इज़ वैलिड डेटा ट्रांसमिशन इन मिलीशियसली और फ्रॉडली रिपीटेड और डिलेड। This is carried out either by the originator or by an adversary who intercept the data and retransmit it. Possibly is a part of masquerade attack by IP packet substitutions. Same as airdropping भी आपको पता है, last time पढ़ाया था हमने। It is a computer security, cyber security or information technology security. It's the protection of computer system and network from the theft or damage to their hardware or software or electronic data as well as from the disruptions or misdirection of services. Okay, Now again the versions you must memorize. The two versions are in common use. The version 4 is the most widely used. The version 4 used for DES data encryption standards. Version 5 is correct some of the security deficiency of version 4. This is updated versions information. Then version 4 overview. A basic third-party authentication scheme is have an authentication server initially negotiates with AS to identify self. NIS provide a non-corruptible authentication credentials, the ticket granting ticket. That means TGT is have a TGS also, the ticket granting server. User subsequently request access to other service form TGS on basis of users TGT. This is a basic overview of version 4. Then a dialogue, that means the steps, the first steps is the obtain a ticket granting from AS once per session. Ek session mein aapko ek hi available ho. Second, obtain a service granting ticket from TGT in which each district service require. In third, the client server exchange to obtain a service on every service request. Direct service request pe aapko contact karna hoga key distribution centers ke. Then TGT which is a timestamp and encrypt it using a TGS. That means ticket granting services is a secret key and returns the encrypted result to the user's workstation. This is done infrequently, typically at user logon. The TGT expires at some point, although it may be transparently renewed by user session manager while they are logging. When the client needs to communicate with service on another node, the client sends the TGT to the TGS, which usually share the same host as a KDC. The service must have already been registered with the TGS with service principal name SPN, and the client used the SPN to request access to the service. After verifying that the TGT is valid and that the user is permitted to access the requested service, the TGS issue ticket and session key to client. The client then send the ticket to service servers along with its service request. This is a basic scenario of Kerberos dialogues. Here you seen in the figure, user client based login and authentications. Here you seen the target servers, few Kerberos negotiations are also there. Authentication server, service server and client are communicating between each other. Here first the client is sent the ID to particular server for authentication. The client send a clear text message of the user ID to authentication server. It's requesting service on behalf of the user. You must remember neither the secret key or nor the password is sent to the authentication server. The authentication server check to see if the client is in database. If it is, the authentication server generate a secret key by hashing the password of the user found at the database. Wo kahan se le gaye wo? Active Directory in Windows server. Wahan pe wo database mein available hoga. Then a message A and message B for TGS and TGT for granting and assessing the particular ticket on basis of network address it is a just simply identifier for a node or a host on a telecommunication network. Then it's used the ticket validity protocol and the client encrypted using the secret key of the TGS. Here you see the password of clients, then you generate a second ticket, then it is a secret key between authentication server and virtual server. Then at last you see the step 3, the IDs plus ticket. Once the client receive a message A and B, it attempt to decrypt a message A with secret key generated from password entered by user. If user a password does not match the password in the authentication server database, the client secret key will be different and it's unable to decrypt a message which is received from A. With a valid password and secret key, the client decrypt a message to A and obtain a client TGT session key. This session key is used for further communication with the TGS. आपको क्या यहाँ पे memorize करना है? The client cannot decrypt a message B as it is encrypted using TGS secret key. At this point, the client has enough information to authenticate itself to the TGS. This is technical parameters, the elaboration, the C for client, AS means authenticate server, V for the server, V for the virtual server, ID C and V is the identifiers, the PC for the password, ADC the network address, and K means secret encryption key shared by AS and V. This is a version 4 dialog to more secure, same as the hierarchicals you see in above. This is authentication, authorization by using the TGTs. Then acknowledgements. There are once the logon session for authorize the passwords and encryption key. The session between here we use a timestamp also. Then the step 3, it is for the ticket granting server, is granting the particular session and the telecommunication from party A to B. Then step number 4, we can get a ticket from server. Once, what type of service? Here, last session में मैंने बोला था कि हर एक session के लिए individual एक synchronized key use होगी. Once again, this is a more secure. Step number 5, we can get a ticket plus authentication data from a server to client. Once per service session. This is the same for the key bureaus. Here we seen in this common unit, the authentication server and ticket granting servers. The same step you need to follow, but it is a more secure and sound. Here you need to remember the client service authorization, client service request, both are a very important point in terms of receiving a message and authorizations. This is a simple but a most secure. Here we continue the same steps in which the client TGT session key is decrypt the message and compare a client IDs. Then again same, this is all about securities and authentications of a data transmission between client and server, in which authentication server is the must verify the identity and security algorithm and a session key. This is all about the overviews and practical approach, how to transmit data and how to process. There are totally 6 steps here we mentioned, which is elaborate in about 4 PPTs. This is a summary and overview of Keeper 4. Here we see in the tickets, this contain information which must be considered private to the user. It allows user to use a service or to access TGS. It's reusable for a period of particular time. It's used for distribution of key securely. Then authenticators is used to prove the client's identity. It proves that the user knows the session key, is prevent replay attack, is used only once and has a very short lifetime. One, authenticator is typically built for session of use of a service. Then realms of Kerberos is a single administrative domain. It includes the server, number of clients, all are registers with servers, the application servers which is used to sharing a key with server. What will happen when user in one realm need access to service from another realm? The Kerberos provide inter-realm authentications. We are continue in the next sessions inter-realm authentications. Thank you. Jai Swaminarayan.